Kenneth Clark Art School, and we're going to be looking at two-point perspective and also at the house that we looked at in our previous video. That beautiful house, that kindergarten house out in Switzerland. And let's go and have a look and see. I have a little trick to show you as well too. So let's go and have a look. Right, here we have that house that was part of the brief video, and we're going to be drawing it, but also we're going to be simplifying quite a bit. There's a tremendous amount of detail inside here, so for our exercise is we're going to be simplifying it and still make a nice beautiful painting, but still a recognizable one. That whoever sees it will still recognize, that's the building. So for explanation of this building, have a look at the previous video, and that will tell you all about the perspective side. So let's go over now. Right, here we are now at the easel, and I have a printout of this, and we're going to do a sketch roughly the same size as this one here, a little bit different to normal, but now we want to work out where are the vanishing points so that we can get this reasonably accurate, except instead of trying to judge with a vanishing point that's way off your actual picture itself. So what I've done is I've got the paper that I'm going to draw on. I've added some extra little pieces of paper on the side. Then I'm going to take and let's plot where the vanishing point is going to be. Now that may be on this piece of paper, or that one, I'm not sure yet, but let's have a look. We're going to take a line that's going to run right across. So let's take the other one. It looks like this one is going to actually be on this paper. So I'm going to take another line that's across here. A few, so we can get that we have the exact point, so that runs nicely across through to there. Let's take that roof, that one across here. This one's a funny little angle. That one runs nicely across there into that area. Let's take a piece of the window along here and then across. So we come generally to this little point here. Now there's the vanishing point. Mark it VP. Now, let's check this other one and see if it does come onto that one. Usually, if it's quite flatter, sometimes you need to get those on the side. But it's just to show you that if you need to, you can add pieces on the paper here, then keep that there, and then we use that vanishing point to do the other side. Oops, let's get this one going. Get that nice little line across there, through to there. This one's on this piece of paper, so that's quite nice. So let's see, let's get a nice line that runs across through to there. Let's take another one down by this window. That runs from there through to there. Now let's take there where that balcony is. There's a nice little line across here. You bring that across. And all in this little area here. They may not be exactly in the same place. As I mentioned in one of the other ones, you get that triangulation. Maybe another one is coming through that area there. So in the middle of that whole lot, you'll take that point, and that's going to be the area of what they call in surveying, the area of triangulation. So we've got that. So now we could actually, what happens if you join up these vanishing lines, that actually gives you your horizon line. And let's take that one. The ruler's not long enough, so what I do is you put those two together, and on that one and that one there, let's rather take that off and I'll show you, you can see it much easier. So let's take that off. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make a mark here for that corner, so then we can work on there. That's very important, is to mark this corner here. In other words, this corner of the building that is the nearest to you. So let's take that off and we're going to put that to the side. So let's get our horizon lines up. Put those two together, and on that point, that one on that point there. So now we can take that and we draw a line right across. Continue that one across there through to the vanishing point. So there's our horizon line, and it's pretty parallel to the bottom here, so that works out quite nice. Okay, so now we need to draw a vertical line. Oh, I don't just see. Unfortunately, if I had a little hole inside here, I could have triangulated that and get a beautiful line straight up straight. But there's another way of doing that. We got something that has got a sharp corner, so let's take that. Let's first of all transfer that mark to about here. Then I'm going to take that, you can use anything that you want to, put that on that line, and then we know that is a perfectly right angles to the other. And let's just continue that one up. Okay, now we need to sort of determine these angles. So that's quite nice. Remember, I had these ones here that I showed you earlier on. So if you want to find a nice little angle, so let's put that. Let's start off with this little line that starts off here at that point. Or that line actually goes right to that corner. So let's get that corner. So I'm going to put that onto there. Then I'm going to swing this until this one is parallel to the paper. So let's get that parallel to the bottom here so I can see it. And that's pretty close into there. So let's take that paper away. To that point, get this parallel. If I take that one and continue that up, we're going to get to that other point. So let's take that. Right, so there we have this point here of the balcony, that point there with the little right across there. So from there you're going to do some judging now. Right, what I should have done is Let's put that back here, get those lines. Just check that. Okay. So what I want to do is I want to get the horizon line here on this drawing so we know where it is, this one here. That's roughly here. Okay. So at that point. And now I can do some judging. It can be roughly the same size, so up to that point is going to be here. The other that little point here. It's that top end, so let's get the top of this balcony. We just graph roughly just maybe about here. I'm not too worried about doing it exactly to proportion. So there's that little balcony. All that is flat towards you. And that's roughly about that width. So let's take a little line through here. Another line through that one. Balcony is roughly that, so vertical, vertical, and through that finishing point. There's that flat balcony, that little piece there, and that window goes up to the top. And if I take that, that this window, top window is going to be about here. And there's another one out that way. Line.